in the very fragmented world we're living in, it's quite important that we are able to understand the environments and conditions we operate in, because we can't always be everything to everyone, and we have to make choices and understand what we're doing. The new monetary order, with, you know, a peak of 450 basis points increase in interest rates in less than 18 months, has been quite demanding on the financial sector in Europe and elsewhere in the world. Nevertheless, I think, you know, banks and insurance companies are taking it quite well. And this should not make us forget that there are also longer term important trends that pose challenges. I'm thinking demography for Europe, I'm thinking tech, I'm thinking the environment. So of course there are, you know, short-term concerns, but we shouldn't be short-sighted and forget that we should be focused on the longer-term ones and the large trends. I can think of, you know, four key points managements should have in mind in order to compete in this new monetary order. One of them is, I would say, the ability to diversify points of view around the table, i.e. make sure that business people talk to ALMT people, talk to modeling people. I think that's very important. The second one would probably be to keep improving, but also questioning our models and predictive abilities, but also question them. And sometimes look, you know, beyond what we see in industry that can come from, you know, sciences, philosophy, novels, in order to imagine what is not there yet and will probably be the next challenge instead of looking in the rearview mirror. So that would be the second one. The third one is rely on a diversified business model, i.e. across geographies, but also business lines. That's very helpful. And the fourth one is develop a form of, I would say, geopolitical bilingualism, because in the very fragmented world we're living in, it's quite important that we are able to understand the environments and conditions we operate in, because we can't always be everything to everyone, and we have to make choices and understand what we're doing. I think technology is probably, with, you know, climate challenges, the most important trend we're facing for the next 10 years. I remember that was 1 year ago when, you know, the world discovered at a large scale generative AI, the excitement we all felt. Of course, there are tons of questions, including ethical ones, that go way beyond, you know, what corporates have to solve, but also there are questions to our societies. But I think also this is going to revolutionize the way we do business, the way we interact with our clients, our processes, the way we build our scoring models. There are many, many new things that's coming with, including with AI, and that are, you know, things to look forward to, but also to question.